people of God, quit attacking man of God by name. Let me tell you something, brother.
You cannot buy your way into heaven with seed money.
I'm Trey Smith. I'm the author of Thieves, One Dirty TV Pastor, and the Man Who Robbed Him. Before setting in to make this particular YouTube video that you're about to watch, I was given access to hundreds of hours worth of footage on a lot of different TV pastors, in this case, Benny Hinn. And at first it was kind of chuckly and giggly because I would look at, you know, you find these spots where the guys seem like they're saying something deceptive or dishonest or in some kind of shady position. And it quickly came to realize that the challenge wasn't to find a place where they were doing something that looked underhanded, but to find somewhere, in this case, where Benny Hinn was telling the truth. But don't take my word for it. I'm going to let Benny tell you himself.
But don't mention people's names on your radio program and your TV program thinking you're doing God service. You're not. You stink, frankly. That's the way I think about it. One verse that said, if you don't like him, kill him. I really wish I could find it.
I remember a man in Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario, that turned into a snake before my eyes, and 2,000 people saw him.
Only those who have been giving to God's work will be spared.
Hallelujah.
Now, you can make checks payable, of course, to Benny Hinn Ministries. If you're using your credit cards, make sure to put your name, your account number, your expiration date, and sign what it says, signature.
When Benny Hinn's show moves on, he doesn't get to see the sadness of the families left in his wake. Laura Twilley's daughters write to their mother every week, still trying to understand how she could die after her miracle.
Let's clear up a couple of things. First of all, about the cures. Do you cure people? Does the Lord cure through you? What really is it?
Well, first of all, I don't cure anybody, Bill. I never said I did.
Release this anointing, and I speak forth the word of deliverance, and I cast every demon out. You devil of cancer, diabetes, heart disease, and AIDS, come out!
He has stopped slinging his suit coat to spread God's anointing.
That lady who came with a tumor, and the tumor fell to the platform. I mean, it fell to the platform. We saw it was something else, and it broke in pieces as it hit the stage.
But your report has enabled me to become more careful.
And remember what he told his own congregation after we questioned why he lived in a $700,000 home and drove a $100,000 Mercedes?
Preachers who live in big homes and drive big cars are to re-examine their calling. And let me tell you something, God has taken me by the neck.
But I'll tell you honestly, I think I'm going to quit preaching healing and start preaching Jesus.
The disease, dear lady, has just died, and you will live.
The Lord has healed you.
Jesus is healing.
Well, there's so many miracles here, I can hardly keep up with them.
On one side, Laura was telling them that I'm healed. You know, mommy's better. I'm not going to need the chemo and the radiation. But yet, on the other hand, when she died, that was the hardest thing for me to do, is to walk in that night and tell the girls that their mother was gone.
I'm simply a minister that likes to help individuals to build their faith so they can believe for healing. Yes, the Lord is the healer. And I've just made myself available.
Does it matter that some people feel that you're a fraud?
In life for free, but you can give them to the birds and bees. I want money. That's what I want.
incredible. And in wake of those promises last year, his ministry now rakes in twice as much as before. More than $2 million a month now. A year ago, he denounced miracles for money.
If I ever stood on a platform and said, I have been to heaven and seen Jesus, leave my meeting.
The Lord spoke to her audibly and said, tell Benny, I'm going to appear physically on the platform in his meetings. Mm. Lord, do it in Phoenix, Arizona, in the name of Jesus.
I want to see it.
Tell me about your visit to heaven. How many visits have you had? Several.
If I ever tell you I can take you to heaven with me to visit Jesus, leave the service.
Suddenly, what appeared to be the bosom of that person appeared the face of Jesus.
Most people have difficulty believing
yes,
that any human being can go to heaven and come back and talk about it.
Yes, that is true.
But seeing the results of your life on earth, I've been with you. I've seen the incredible work you have in India.
Yet some, please forgive me, simple-minded people have sat in meetings and listened to such nonsense of people telling them they have visited heaven and gone and talked to Abraham and had coffee with him.
Pastor, let me tell you something. I've seen angels myself. For a whole year in my bedroom, I saw angels in 74. And every so often, I still see them. I mean, I've had experiences with angels. They'll get your hair to stand up even with hairspray on it.
A perfect healing.
So they must be healed.
Exactly.
So if she's not healed.
If she's not healed,
you got a problem.
We have a problem. Do you know something about it that I don't know?
Well, we know nobody called this woman's doctor before Benny ran and reran this miracle healing on TV. We know one of those children is not even hers. And we know the lady has not been healed of AIDS because just this week, we had her tested to find out.
But you also say you only put on television miracles, miracle healings, which have been medically verified and proven.
You know, Bob,
so all we want to do is see the basis on which you say that.
We have done all that we can do as a ministry to open a department, to have people check.
You remember the little boy named William in Las Vegas a couple of years ago? You made him a star. You were going to set up a trust fund for him. You were going to put him through university. He was supposedly cured of blindness. He's not cured of blindness.
We have a hot victims hotline where people call us with their stories. And the stories are endless of people who had loved ones die after they were proclaimed on television that they were healed, having little children told that they were healed of hearing or eyesight or innumerable, or the reason you weren't healed is you didn't give enough money.
Absolutely, I need a private plane for the ministry. It's a necessity. Look, every man of God that I know today has a nice house.
Not a luxury.
I mean, if I should fly commercial, I would wear out.
I was able to buy a beautiful Cessna Citation jet, cash. A few months later, bought another jet worth three times what that one was. A little bit later, bought a third jet. Bought them all three.
I want to love and be loved.
Call us now and say, I'm one of those planting a seed for uncommon favor for 12 months with God and man. We're rushing the world, by the way.
And I've never claimed to be a Messiah or anyone special. I'm a little Messiah walking on earth, in other words.
Tonight, the ministry of Benny Hinn responds to an iFiles investigation which revealed two heroin-related deaths within his ministry.
After returning from California this week, Hinn spoke to his employees about the public revelations. He also sent someone to talk to our Tony Pipitone.
Benny Hinn had agreed to talk to us in person about his church, but canceled after seeing our report last week. Instead, he sent a spokesman who says Hinn is upset about that report, a report on the role of heroin in the deaths of two employees. His employees was David Delgado, one of Benny Hinn's personal assistants, the man helping Hinn into his jacket before a crusade appearance last year. This is video from last December on what would be his last trip with Pastor Hinn. At the time, an Orange County homicide investigator was looking to question Delgado about the source of heroin that just weeks earlier had killed another employee of World Outreach Church.
Hello, hello, hello.
A man Hinn had trusted to babysit his children years ago. But the questioning never happened, because by the end of 1997, Delgado too was dead, a result of heroin abuse.
These eyes. I have never lied to you. Never. I never will. I'd rather die than lie to God's people.
The very first woman you brought up on stage in Albuquerque was presented by you as being cured, a miraculous walk. But we saw her walking and chatting with one of your staff before your show even began.
Let me tell you something. That woman was a fake.
Though Hinn refuses to make his financial information public, he has said that every dollar given to his ministry goes to the work of the Lord. His home is this mansion overlooking the Pacific Ocean, built and paid for by his ministry. The ministry told us the mansion was its parsonage and a good investment. Travels in this private jet. According to documents we obtained, the ministry pays more than $112,000 a month to use the plane. This photo obtained by Dateline shows him getting out of a Mercedes SUV, and here he is driving a Mercedes convertible. Listen to what this former Hinn insider says.
There was never one complete record that would suit the criteria for a documented miracle healing, and that troubled me deeply. To me, this was a fraud.
According to her husband, she left that auditorium instructed by your staff not to go ahead with her chemotherapy, her radiation, or even her pain relief because she'd been healed.
I would like to know who the staff member was who said that to her.
I place a curse on every man and every woman that will stretch his hand against this anointing. I curse that man who dares to speak a word against this ministry.
Small detail that a lot of people don't know about me. My mother is, some people call it a miracle, other people, you call it a medical anomaly. But she was given 3 months to live or less by doctors. That was about 20 years ago. I sat down and had lunch with her a few weeks ago. She spent a lot of her life actually with terminally people with cancer, people with other terminal sicknesses. In some cases, she spent years with folks. Never asked them for anything. In fact, in some cases, she would actually come out of her own pocket for people that were sick or dying from something. Benny, in your case, I can't find any situation where you have cared for anybody other than yourself. And it's not for lack of looking. I could find graves from people who washed up on your doorstep and did the best that they could to give what little they had to you. And in 40 years, the mechanisms you've got are top notch for getting dollar bills from them to you. Benny, shame on you, and shame on us for listening. My name's Trey Smith. I'm the author of Thieves, One Dirty TV Pastor, and The Man Who Robbed Him. I'm not going to tell you what the book is. Type in Trey Smith Thieves into your search browser and figure out more about who I am. Thank you for watching. There's a lot more to come.
Interpretation of a seed that can move mountains is the seed of money. The seed of money has no value to the Lord Jehovah, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. You cannot buy your way into heaven with seed money.